I'm proud of my president. I am thinking that he became a national hero in these 4 days. I think he's doing everything right. And according, for example, to yesterday, 198 civil people died in Ukraine, while Russian media, they are saying that there is no civil death in Ukraine and Ukraine is bombing themselves by themselves. But, you know, this is kind of ridiculous because before that, Georgia was bombing themselves by themselves. Now Ukraine is bombing themselves by themselves. So they are very unlucky to have such neighbors. Everyone is bombing themselves by themselves. And I'm sure all the world is understanding that this is a genocide of Ukrainian people and this aggression is coming from Russian side.
Anastasia, we're really, again, all we could say is our sympathies. Like, we are really sorry what is happening. We know that the suffering of war can be beyond just pain for, like, at the moment, but also in the future because it stays with you forever. So all we can say is we are really sorry that your family and your country is going through what they're going through. We'll try our best to just try to get as much of the word as possible of what's happening. Now, you guys, the Ukrainian community is not really big in Erbil, but you have a good community. You're coming together today. Tell us exactly what's happening and why are you doing it and what do you want to achieve from it?
I wouldn't call it a protest. I would call it a peaceful meeting. We just want to show the world and we want to show Ukraine our moral support. This is the minimum what we can do right now. And, you know, actions, they are better than any talks. And I'm sure our president, Vladimir Zelensky, is proving this by the first day of in this war. So we're going to gather at 10 o'clock near UN building and we're going to just show our support to Ukrainian army, to Ukraine. And we are inviting all Kurdish people and other nationalities to join us and just show the solidarity that people are against the war.
Okay, and that's going to be happening in front of the UN on the 100 meter road at 10 a.m.
Yes, that's correct.
What is the plan for the community here? Are you guys going to try to do anything in terms of, I don't know, fundraising? Because now we're seeing that, for example, the Ukrainian government has begun doing an online fundraiser to keep up with everything that they are trying to do.
Yes, and I already did that myself. I'm sending money to army to support them. And if we are talking, I'm going to talk about myself. My father, he's an ex-military, he's an ex-colonel, and himself, even he is over 50 years old, he's gonna go and protect this country. And if I would be in Ukraine, I would take Kalashnikov and I would go to protect my country.
Wow. Well, that is mad respect. I mean, we talked about earlier how Ukraine has been independent for 30 years and you can't go back to something after you have tasted freedom. So we can understand, while, you know, your message sounds really strong and tough, but it is what it is because you want your land to be free. Explain to us in terms of what do you think is going to be happening this coming week? What do you hope for? Because we heard that there was possibility of negotiations, but we heard President of Ukraine saying those negotiations, the conditions were unrealistic, so they didn't happen. So that's why the fighting resumed again. But what do you wish for? How can we get out of this mess?
Well, I wish for peace. I'm sure, like everyone in this world, I hope they're gonna be stop of the fire. But I'm also sure that we will not accept any things like Russia is wanting currently.
Which is what? To control all of Ukraine?
Which is control of Ukraine, yes.
Okay. Well, like Dalawi said, all we want is peace. So we hope in some kind of a way peace comes real soon. Yes, Dalai.
I feel like thing Putin wants to like create the, you know, the old thing. What's the old Russian Federation?
Soviet Union.
Soviet
the
old, Union.
Yeah, he wants to create the Soviet Union again, and the Soviet Union was destroyed for a bunch of reasons. And the people of Ukraine, I don't know, but Kiev was one of the hubs of the world, and it was Ukraine was doing amazingly, and I feel like the Russian people saw that, and they did what happened in Germany back in the day too, when Russia divided Germany, when the old Soviet Union divided Germany. So my heart goes out to everyone in Ukraine, and as you see here, like, the Ukrainian people are willing to fight, but at the same time, they won't want peace. They're not fighting because for the heck of it, they're fighting for their country. But if peace is on the table, they want peace. And like, I know everyone listening is probably thinking about like, what about us and stuff like that. Not everything is about us, first of all. And second of all, we want world peace. We just don't want peace in Kurdistan. I want the whole
everywhere.
World to be, yeah, I want the whole world to be at peace, because we as Kurds know how hard it is to leave your country, fight for your country, die for your country. We know more than most, and my heart goes out to all the Ukrainian people listening and all the Ukrainian people of the world.
Anastasia, what is your thoughts about the international community's response so far? In the beginning, it was really, really bad, but now we're hearing reports that European countries and even the U.S. are starting to deliver military equipment. So what do you think? You took a deep breath when I said that, but go ahead. Tell us, how do you feel about that?
As per our president, we are really appreciated for the support that we received so far from the U.S. It's not just U.S., it's Canada and other countries in Europe. Equipment is coming. Turkish president also closing the Bosporus for the Russian ships not to pass. So we are appreciating this. But every day our president is saying that we need more support, and we do need more support from the world. And I hope it will be done. The sanctions are starting. They're going to close the SWIFT for the banks in Russia. They're going to apply, I'm sure, other sanctions as well. And we are hoping it's going to finish as soon as possible.
Do you think the world is helping Ukraine to this point just because to save face? It's not enough, but they're just doing as little as possible, so their people are like, hey, look, we helped Ukraine.
Yeah, do you think it's genuine, the help, or do you think it's not genuine enough?
I think it should be more.
Yeah.
Well, a lot of things already have been happening. You talked about the SWIFT. That is probably the most important thing that's happened.
That's huge.
But also other things began from day one. For example, the Champions League final was supposed to be in Russia.
Yeah.
And it has moved to Paris. The Formula One event was supposed to happen soon. Cancelled. Poland has said they're not going to be playing a Russian football team in the upcoming World Cup. So maybe even that would mean that Russia would be kicked out of the World Cup qualifiers for the World Cup that is happening this year in Qatar. So hopefully the idea is all these different kind of pressure. Chelsea, the Russian owner of Chelsea, he gave up his team. He owns it, but he signed off yesterday saying, "Khalas, I don't own it," because they put sanctions on him. He's not even allowed to enter the UK anymore, yet he owns one of the most prestigious clubs in the UK. So hopefully all these kind of different pressures, with SWIFT, of course, being the biggest one, would lead to some kind of ease
yeah.
to start de-escalating and then start negotiating a peaceful but, way to get out of this crisis.
But no, we're forgetting one thing. When all these things happen, it's punishing the Russian people. And we saw the Russian people in the streets protesting against this war.
We saw some. How did you feel when you saw that, Anastasia?
I felt, you know, I'm sure I'm not the only one who is like crying every day, but I felt warm. I felt supported. I have Russian friends. I have relatives who are living in Russia, and they're all just sending messages and calling how we can help, what we can do. Is there something? How's your family? So it's not about Russian people, okay? We are, like, we can say brothers, you know, brothers and sisters with them. It is about the aggression of the Russian government. I'm sure there are a lot of Russian people who are smart And when they are seeing that propaganda on the internet, that fake news on the internet, they are able to check CNN or any other kind of news, international news, and just be logical. Critical thinking is something that you need to have, not just during the war, but in this century. And I'm sure the Russians, some Russians, they have that critical thinking.
Definitely. I agree with everything you said. We have Thulfakhir checking in saying, as an Iraqi, I do understand a little bit of how, or I do understand how the Ukrainians feel right now because of the war, and I pray for them to be safe and for this to be ending ASAP. But it's all about world powers, Russia never accepting NATO and things like that. He also sent a message to you in Ukrainian, but I can't read it. I'll send it to you.
Okay, most probably it's Slava Ukraini.
Perhaps something like that.
This is,
what does that mean?
It means glory to Ukraine.
How do you say that?
Slava Ukraini.
Wait.
You should say it.
We're going to. Okay. Slava.
Slava.
Slava
Ukraini.
Slava Ukraini.
Yeah. Slava Ukraini. Slava
and Ukraine. I'm really so appreciated for all the support from Kurdish people, but there should be some actions. That's why I'm calling everyone at 10 o'clock near the UN building just to support us. Show your support.
You can come today. You can take some time off from work and stand there with Anastasia, hand in hand, to show solidarity. Nothing will change with the one protest, but just being there as a human is something really special. So, Anastasia, we wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
We, again, are really sorry. We wish none of this had happened. And all we can do is just from here, at least from Erbil, is morally support, and hopefully it will lead to a better situation in the future. Good luck with everything that you're going to be doing today and your team. Anything you want to say before we say goodbye to you? Anything you want to say to anybody listening?
Again, I want to say thank you and Slava Ukraini.
Slava Ukraini.
Slava Ukraini.
Thank you so much. Good luck.